I'm thinking, you guys. I'm thinking and I'm moving.
Cute. We're looking for upscale to elevate Connie's style.
Help. The cape, the asymmetrical. I don't know what to do.
What if I got her a shirt that said Angel Baby? The sparkle and everything on top of it. Oh, she'd hate it. I'm gonna hold on to it for a sec.
I'm Connie, this is my twin sister, and this is a stylist, and today we're going to be seeing which of them can style me best for a girl's night out. I've been a twin to Connie for our entire lives, and we live together. Our closet is an open door policy. We've been like, I guess, styling each other for years now, so this is just another day in the life, basically. She definitely knows what I like at this point, but we have a professional stylist here.
Hey. So I'm Dawn, and I've been doing wardrobe styling for about 8 or 9 years, usually up and coming artists and public figures. So I'm really passionate about what I do. I love it and I'm excited to dress you.
Girls' night out for me typically is like, obviously, Caryn's there.
Thank you.
And then the other set of our girlfriends that we have are all in very committed relationships. Because of that, they have decided that it's now their passion project to try to hook us up with anybody who is in the general vicinity. Because of that, my first word that I ended up picking, I picked flirty because I didn't want to put romantic on it, because sometimes when you say the word, people think you mean old and chastity. They think that you're supposed to be like super conservative, and that's not really what I'm going for. I like a lot of the aesthetic. I don't want to look like an Edwardian romance heroine late at night with my candlelight going, writing letters, lots of ruffles, big hair. Not what I'm going for.
Oh, that's all I'm gonna get you.
So I picked fashionable because of that. And then my last one was unique. So I always feel like I wanna be unique and different and stand out, because I don't want to look too similar like someone who has my exact genetic DNA who is normally tagging along. So there are some rules for this. They need to pick out a full outfit for me. They need to have between 2 to 4 accessories, and it has to be those 3 keywords of flirty, fashionable, and unique.
Listen, I think Dawn's gonna kill it, and I want that understood. But also, I feel like I definitely know your style. I know what you like.
I will admit, I'm a little nervous because, I mean, it's a twin. A twin is a twin. You know each other inside out, and I have a feeling Caryn is gonna be very good competition. I feel like my advantage to this challenge is that I've kind of been studying Miss Connie here and doing my best to figure out personality-wise what I feel would accentuate her attributes and make her look exactly the way that she feels on the inside.
Okay, ladies, it's time to go shopping. Are you guys ready?
Let's do it.
Okay, great.
We are here at H&M in Century City. Gotta keep Connie's words in mind, which were flirty, fashionable, unique, and also hot.
We're gonna make it look hot.
There's so much cute stuff here. I heard there's something called modern romance, which is like basically what Connie is, so should be pretty easy. I think we got this, let's go.
So I just left Connie, and she left me with some wonders to think about. I have pulled some really amazing things to get on that path, so here we go.
First dress that catches my eye is this cute little number. This is very up Connie's alley. She's loving a floral print lately, and the buttons all the way down, so her. Ooh, or the red. I'm also having to fight with myself to like not pick out something she would hate, because I do think that would be really funny, but I know that's not the challenge and I do want to win, so I'm not gonna do that.
I love this ribbed crop top. It's got these wide wrists and these pearl pierced accents. I think it's flirty and I think it's fashionable, and it really kind of reminds me of Connie and her personality, just flowing really cute. This skirt right here, I really love because, well, it's got this shiny wet look thing going on, which I think she can really carry, but it's also pencil style, so it's gonna accentuate her curves and shape her like very well. This guy, I really like this guy. He's gold, he shimmers, he says flirty, he says fashionable, and he definitely says unique. I think this is going to beautify her being, and I think she would look really great and have a good time in this.
I do think she would really like that. Connie loves overalls, she like lives in them, and if we could find a cute little flirty top to go underneath,
That would maybe be a winner. Ooh, cute. She'd love this. She'd love this. Oh, I'm gonna win, no problem. Oh, this is so easy. This, I'm thinking, maybe underneath that little black overall number. That is a bit like fashionable, unique. This is flirty. All the words, I've got all the words.
I really like this guy. It's a simple piece, but it's really in your face. Then you turn it around, and it's like booty. Gotta bring the girls, gotta bring the booty.
Connie is not a body kind of girl. She's much more a fit and flare silhouette, because she's gotta be free to like move and like have fun. So we're not gonna do a body con.
I fell in love with this set because of the color. I just feel like she'll be like a walking glass of champagne. Isn't that fun? I really love this piece because, once again, it's simple, but it's in your face, still fashionable. It's got its flirty elements to it. And what sells me every time is pockets. So I really think Connie would look great. I think it would complement her skin tone. I think that it really goes with her modern romantic vibe.
She loves this style right now because what's great about this is it like cinches into your body so you still have a good like showing of your actual silhouette, but then like the sleeves are all out and cute and flirty and you can like show off a little bit of that shoulder action.
Fur, love fur, fake faux. Faux fur. This guy is lovely. It's got muted tones. It's unique because of the pattern. You really don't see these colors go together very often. And then it's not full length, it's not half length, it's cropped, so it will still snatch the waist.
I think I'm gonna go back to that rack and kind of pick out a couple, because I think I've got the stuff. Except for this red top, which I'm also gonna pick up. Okay, to the rack. So I'm gonna try and go through here and narrow it down to like a couple of options. My first thought upon coming in here was get her a cute dress, because she's gonna love that. I like both of these. As for not dresses, we've got a couple of little like overall numbers. I'm a little worried that maybe this might be a bit too casual, but our going out nights are always very casual. I love this. It's a little outside of what she has in her closet right now, but this is exactly like stuff that she pins on Pinterest or stuff that I've seen whenever we're going about. She'll be like, ooh, cute, but maybe I can't wear that. And this would be a chance to try and wear that. I like the idea of these two together because it's not just a plain something underneath this. It's got a little bit of pizzazz. So I'm thinking about that.
So pondering. You know, I really, really love this and I think that she would look great in this. I think this guy is a really good contender. Something about this says Connie to me. As much as I like you, you maybe for another time. For some reason, I just keep on coming back to this. Now, I know it may look a little basic, but dressed up and accessorized, I think it would look really great for a girls' night out.
I'm down to two options. This shirt and this little jumper to go over top. So flirty, because we got a little sheer action going on. Very fashionable, obviously, and unique. I mean, nobody but Connie's gonna pull this off and look great. And my second option is a little dress number that I know that she'll love. I think we need to like make this a bit flashier, so I'll probably end up getting her maybe a denim jacket with it. So yeah, these are my final two options. And I just gotta decide which one to go. And we gotta get some accessories too.
I brought some really great purses. We got the silver beaded joint. I really love this vintage leopard with the puffy fur with the beaded handles. Like, it's just so dainty and cool, but it's still kind of unique. This is simple, but I really like the pattern. I love the embroidered roses. I love the black and white. It's very busy, but it still has like its focal point.
Connie isn't much for accessories, like when it comes to like earrings and necklaces and bracelets and stuff. She's a very minimal girl, but she always wears a locket, like a cute little heart locket. And if I could find her something small, minimal, but cute, then I think that she would really like it. If I could find like a star or a moon or something, great. Almost like that, but if it had less. If it had less. Yes, just like this. We have just a little moon pendant. She's gonna love that. I'm debating between the gold and the silver because I think the gold goes with one outfit and the silver goes with the other. Connie is much more of a gold gal, but I don't want to mix metals on her.
Some of the other accessories that I chose, a lovely Chanel bracelet. Ooh, we can't go wrong with Chanel. Got the Marc Jacobs bracelet here. Just a nice little charm bracelet. Got the Coco CC necklace. I think would look really nice just right there on her. These guys are really fun because they are reversible. So you can wear them in the front or you can wear them in the back. You've got simple studs and then you've got flair. You've got a ball of pearls, you've got a disco ball, and you've got a snow globe. Like, look, there's a snow globe in there.
Connie's very specific when it comes to bags. She wants something that she can like put her phone, her wallet, and her keys in and like still have room, but also it be cute. And she loves a circle bag. I like this, she loves this. And see how big everything is in there. It's pretty big in there, honestly. This is kind of like the big version of this little mini bag. I wonder if she would like that. This is what I'm going with. I think that we just have shoes left, really. Maybe a headband. I'm gonna look at headbands just real quick. This would be the color. And it would kind of, ooh, it might be too much for her. But we might have to try because it would look so cute. So I'm a bit overwhelmed. I just have to keep reminding myself I know what she likes. I know what she likes. She's much more of a like thicker sort of a heel as opposed to like a skinny little stiletto. This is it. This is the vibe. We found it. I think we're either gonna do this shoe here or there's a cute little chunk boot. Ooh, she would love those if there's a right size. She's not very much like an open toe girl. Neither am I. But maybe pushing her outside her comfort zone would be good. And also, this is like the exact sort of heel she would like. And she doesn't own anything like this, which is kind of nice too.
I love these booties. They're like little witchy booties. They have the thick ribbon laces. They're suede and they've got the chunky heel, which is in. They're very fashionable, but they're comfortable. When you're going out on a girl's night, the last thing you want is for your feet to hurt. These pumps, very simple. Patent leather, black pumps, never go out of style, goes with everything, accentuates your ankles, your calves, which brings you up toward the leg, and every girl should own a good pair of black patent leather pumps. So I like these nude pumps as well. They kind of give you naked vibes because they're flesh toned. So those are subliminal messages that go off to the people around you when you're out partying, shaking it, and trying to maybe attract something that you want to attract.
So here is option number one. She's got some version of all of these pieces in our wardrobe already. So I know that she likes this stuff. It's a really good safe bet option that I think I could win with. But we also have option number two. We're gonna call this one the risk. And that's because we've got a couple of factors in here that aren't Connie's normal sort of styling, but stuff that I'm pretty sure she's gonna love. And maybe we can one up our stylist. Maybe I'm a stylist now, I don't know. So now I just have to pick which route I'm going for. Both have their pluses and minuses, but I think she's gonna love it either way. I'm very confident right now. I think I'm gonna win, no problem.
We really gotta make some decisions. So the flirty top with the leopard pouch and the fur, fashionable, definitely unique and definitely flirty. With the skirt, fun, wet look, slick, with the booties, and the pouch, and probably one of the fun stud reversible earrings. This beauty queen right here, which like I said, it's simple, but it's very flirty, it's frilly, it's like flowy, and the wristlet accentuates and really brings out the patterns. The patterns are different. It says fun, it does say flirty, it does say fashionable. And then the stockings, bringing out those legs. The shoes that I think I'm gonna pair this dress with are the pumps. I like this because it says something very specific and it's flirty. So I think I've made my decision and I'm gonna take my pick over to Connie and we're gonna pray.
Okay, my eyes are closed. I have not seen either outfit yet. I'm going to open my eyes and see what they are now. Oh, oh, oh! Oh my gosh, everything is so cute. Yeah. Okay, this is really tough. I don't know whose is whose. I'm gonna say this is Caryn's and this is the stylist's. Did I do it?
You did it.
Ah, darn. Ding, 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 ding.
I love this bag, Dawn. Oh, that is so cool. Okay, now this all makes sense to me. The reason I said that this one is Caryn's and this one is Dawn's is because Caryn knows that I love an overall. That makes complete sense. Now this looks a lot like my Instagram. So that makes sense why Dawn would have picked this. All right, I guess I'm gonna go try them on.
Connie, are you ready?
I'm ready.
Come on up.
Okay. And...
Oh. Oh, wow.
My darling girl!
So, this is it. I haven't really seen it yet.
Oh, Caryn, you did a really good job. I knew this one was Caryn immediately. It screams everything that's everyday me. That's exactly it. I love it though. I love the whole look. I love the cute little flowers. I love the overalls. They are maybe a little shorter than I would usually go, but hey.
That's the flirty.
Flirty. That's the flirty. I've wanted one of these headbands for so long, so I think it's really cute.
It's like the Christmas.
That's exactly it. We're normally not open toe people, not usually my vibe, but I really love the shape of these and I love all the straps and the little details. You did a good job adding a bunch of different elements.
How good did I do?
Okay. We haven't seen Dawn's yet. You can't already have
slow down.
For flirty, I mean, there's a see-through element, so I'm feeling pretty good. For fashionable, I think this looks very now. I think it looks very trendy and current. Unique, that might be the only part where it might take a couple of points off, just because it does look maybe like a little like somebody else could have this look. But I think you did a really good job like pairing other things together that I don't think anybody would do maybe this specific look with all the accessories added together.
I agree. So unique.
So far, we're off to a great start, and I'm really excited to see Dawn's now.
Hey.
Connie! You ready, girl?
Oh my!
Oh my gosh, why do you look so pretty?
Oh my gosh.
Oh no, you look too pretty. Go back in there. Okay, I feel, I don't know, elegant, like Cinderella at a ball. Look at me. It's so interesting that you took all those words that I said and made this, because this is so like what I would think whenever I would take my style to like a night look. This is exactly it. I love all the little details that are all over. You have like the little pearl details here on the sleeves. Also, if you look at the bottom of the sleeves, they kind of bell out just a little bit, like a little butterfly, and they're absolutely beautiful. I wear tons of mock neck stuff. I wear a lot of turtlenecks and things. This is exactly what I wear. What I don't normally wear is I don't ever wear anything that's kind of like bodycon, but I surprisingly like this skirt a lot.
You look hot.
I usually am like so not into like a bodycon, but it hits like at just the right place. The little details here when we're talking accessories of these earrings, I love these earrings. And not only are these earrings beautiful from the front, but they're also reversible. This is just the cutest thing I've ever seen in my dadgum life. So I love this idea of like this little bag, and it looks like it would fit all the stuff that I need it to. My phone, it looks like it would fit all my credit cards, ID, all that
stuff. You might
sort
have to condense a bit.
Okay, yeah, I might have to just a little bit.
I picked this outfit for Connie because it really speaks to her personality. I chose the skirt because it was flirty and fashionable, but what makes it unique is the slick kind of wet look. And that makes it nighttime wear and fun to go out. Like, this is definitely a girl's night out skirt. I just really fell in love with these booties because they're a mix between an Edwardian, Victorian, yes, shoe, but there's something very current about it. And I just thought it all came together and it really did. It's the essence of how she described the way she wanted to look.
Flirty? I mean, come on now. Look at this. We are definitely rocking a bodycon thing. I'm not used to showing this much of this old body, and it looks great. And fashionable, I think it's very fashion forward. I think we're mixing a lot of different things all together, which just makes it seem not only just fashionable, but even unique. I think that's something really great about a stylist, is something, these are just pieces that nobody would put all together, and they couldn't find them all just in one department store, pick them up and take them out. This is something that she's curated and cultivated, and it looks just like that. All right, now I guess I gotta just change back in my regular old outfit, and then I have to make some kind of decision on who wins. You both won, you definitely both won, but I'm just gonna say some words after this and it'll be fine. You both did a great job. I just wanna lead off with that, like to be—
Thank you. Good job, Dawn.
Yes, please shake hands.
Yes.
To be completely honest, it's been a really weird year for me. I haven't necessarily felt like really pretty in a while. It was like just felt really good, and it was just like, I thank you both. Now one of you has to lose. Caryn's outfit was just literally, I would walk out the door into BuzzFeed, go sit next to my desk friend upstairs, and he would go, "Hey, Connie," and he wouldn't say a second thing. He'd be like, "This is just the Connie I know and love." Dawn's outfit was something that pushed me a little bit and did some things that I like, normally I'm like, oh, I have all these rules in my head that are like, you can't wear that because it does this, you can't wear that because it does this. And I was like checking those boxes and then seeing that maybe I was actually like just boxing myself in instead. So it was really nice to be pushed and see something different on my body that I actually kind of liked. With that being said, I think I have to go with Dawn's outfit.
As soon as I saw those sleeves, I knew you would.
I really think you did like such a perfect job.
Yeah, it's just okay.
It's just exciting to see something that I thought that I couldn't wear. I thought it was something that wasn't an option for me. And that was really exciting to see that maybe I could wear it and have something fun. So yeah, for that, definitely for Dawn's.
Well, I feel like slightly robbed because obviously you would wear this. I completely get it. Dawn's outfit is something that I really have never seen you in and loved you in.
Thanks.
So like, I get it. It's not like you don't.
I am thankful. So thank you. Caryn, I think you did a wonderful job.
Thank you.
Connie really loves the outfit, and I'm really glad that I was able to push you a little bit through your boundaries. And now you know you do not have to live in that box. That is a mental box that you can just break on out of anytime you want, so I'm happy to help with that.
Thank you.
And you look great in both outfits.
Thank you. Thank you, Dawn.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Roll, come on.
You're welcome.
Yes.